The importance of bone health. We all know that bone health is important for various reasons now, but it really is, you know, protects our vital organs from injury. It's, you know, supports us and allows us to move and do what we would like. But it's also really our storage system. So it really stores minerals like calcium and phosphorus and really are released when we need them, when blood levels drop. So peak bone mass age, again, just as a reminder, is really about up to the age of 30 in women, and really about 75 to 85% of our skeleton is built during adolescence. And then we lose calcium as adults. So another reason to look forward to being 30. We do need sufficient bone nutrients like calcium and vitamin D, and really to build the best, strongest bone, but really also to maintain that bone. So keeping bones healthy, there's a whole slew of things here: healthy food choices, well-balanced diet. It's seemingly very easy to say that. Eating foods rich in calcium and vitamin D, your vitamin mineral supplementation if and when needed, exercise, physical activity, and good health and habits. So the nutrition part is really, part of it is trying to hit all the food groups, making sure you get all of these crucial nutrients from food. That's what food gave us years ago. It was our, you know, adds hydration, it gives us fiber, gives us vitamins and minerals that we might not be getting anywhere else. Really, your good nutrition is also going to help maintain and support a good, healthy weight and your soft tissue, which is really protecting your bones. Really not useful to focus on just a few nutrients. One of the things I think whenever I'm talking about any topic, people always say, what is the best diet for? And you can fill in the blank. So it could be arthritis, it could be osteoporosis, and really one of the main things is always general good nutrition. And so this is sort of, if anyone's ever seen this, I don't know if you have, years ago, a lot of people might remember the food guide pyramid, and then it was replaced with something that looked like a crazy pie chart, which every healthcare professional kind of rioted about, and then they switched it to this. This is more user-friendly. It is definitely ideal and not necessarily super realistic, but what it does show is, one, eating color, two, trying to get all the food groups as much as possible every time you eat. And I'm not going to necessarily say meals, because if you're more of a grazer, fine. So bone-healthy foods, simply, it's sort of dairy, canned, you know, fish with bones, fatty fish. Those are unfortunately the three kind of major food groups. And if you unfortunately don't eat them, if you're vegan, then you have to figure out other ways. So a lot of this, I don't want everyone to walk away from this thinking that I am a dairy pusher, but I am here to give you information based on where the richest sources of these nutrients are, and then you can take it from there. So your bone healthy foods, I mean, this is sort of just, you know, kind of more in detail, sort of your dark green leafies, you know, there's a lot of color here, your fruit, you know, potatoes, tomatoes, bananas, you know, everything here has specific nutrients, your calcium, your sort of minerals. And so food first. It is the preferred, again, source of nutrients for the body, and it's our, you know, vitamins and minerals. And typically it does help with dietary patterns. So if people are typically eating a lot of fruits and vegetables, and they have some dairy, and they have some beans and low-fat protein foods, then typically they're usually in a good place. And it really does, nutrient density just means the foods that you are eating are pretty nutritious on a regular basis. So the overall message regarding food is really variety and moderation, you know, trying to vary your daily intake. Most of us are creatures of habit, and we usually, if you think about yourself, most people tend to have about 4 to 5 different meals, like from a lunch perspective and a dinner perspective. And even if you're going out to dinner or going to certain restaurants, you tend to go for a specific meal. Most people haven't gone and tried everything on the menu. So you really want to try to work on varying your intake as possible and trying to hit all the food groups if you can, and really having calcium-rich foods as they are available and as you can fit them into your diet. It's always diet, diet, diet. That's how we, you know, promote any nutrient first, and if you are unable to, then you would fill in the gaps with supplements as needed.